who humiliated Miz and Morrison. Bad Bunny's here live for that match later on tonight. But right now, it's Charlotte Flair, one-on-one with Lacey Evans. Charlotte Flair damaging her left shoulder before the commercial break. Oh, Lacey Evans sending Flair into the steel steps.
Right now, Charlotte is absolutely infuriated. She is sick and tired of these antics.
Oh, God. Remember, that's the left arm that was injured last summer by Nia Jax. This has been a nagging injury for Charlotte Flair.
And Tom, it begs the question, how much of that influence, how much of that scouting on that bad shoulder was a credit of Ric Flair?
Very good point. Now, this is before the break. Boom, left shoulder first into the steel steps and Byron. Remember what Lacey Evans said. WWE officials, thanks to Ric Flair, have told Evans that if she beats Charlotte Flair, she'll get a Raw Women's title match.
Lacey Evans feels like WWE officials will give her a championship opportunity against Asuka, assuming that she does defeat Charlotte Flair.
Again, can you believe Evans? Can you believe Ric Flair at this point?
No, it's disturbing. It's sickening. And the fact that Lacey Evans came out here and actually had the audacity to offer to team with Charlotte Flair to try to play innocent and all this.
Now Flair all on, went for the cover. Oh, follows up on Charlotte 2.0 as Flair called Lacey Evans.
Charlotte 2.0 or not, I mean, Charlotte Flair is obviously favoring that shoulder. I mean,
oh, man, and using the left arm to toss Flair, who follows up with a drop kick.
But to Flair's credit, she's been absolutely relentless, doing her best not to show any signs that she's hurt at all.
This is what the queen does, Joe, overcoming adversity, dealing with obstacles, finding a way.
Oh, man, and again, damage to the arm, sweeps out the legs.
There's only so much you can hide, Byron. And all that damage to that shoulder is beginning to show up.
Oh, Lacey Evans into the midsection, and this is just nasty.
You know, I'm sure Lacey Evans has learned quite a bit under the quote-unquote learning tree of Ric Flair, but again, it's the method of doing so, the method of targeting and trying to ruin the career of Charlotte Flair in the process. That's the issue here.
Oh!
And the focus on the arm. I mean, Lacey Evans. I mean, is this Ric Flair's influence?
Well, think about how livid Ric Flair was before the break, Byron. We haven't seen Ric like that in a while.
Well, when have you ever heard Ric Flair say, "I am tired of hearing how great Charlotte Flair is"? Ric Flair has always been Charlotte Flair's number one cheerleader, number one supporter.
Hold on. Charlotte was trying to set up maybe for the figure four. Evans saw it coming, got to the bottom rope.
Yeah, that may be the case, Byron, but let's be honest here. Charlotte's been rife with disrespect for her father, and she hasn't appreciated him, interjecting himself in some of her matches.
Because that's what is being said. That's what Ric Flair has said. So you believe that's how Charlotte Flair has treated her father?
I don't know how you were raised, Byron, but you respect your elders no matter what.
And Joe, it's beyond interjecting themselves in matches. They cost Charlotte a championship, the women's tag team titles, last week at the Royal Rumble event.
And again!
Flair driven down, but gets back up.
The queen defiant and daring Lacey Evans.
This has turned into an all-out brawl. Now Lacey Evans off the ropes. Now Lacey Evans styling.
Look at this. No shame at all.
None whatsoever.
And Charlotte is profiling and now has got a hold of Lacey Evans.
Yeah, I hope it was worth it, Lacey.
And tossing Evans right in front of Ric Flair.
Charlotte Flair, yeah, that's how you do it. Flair eyeing her father.
Put himself between Charlotte and Lacey. Face first into the apron. This match continues live.